drink. This is the only time it's going to happen while we're open today, so feel free to stick around and watch that happen. Now that we've got just a few more moments before the drink, and I have some questions for all of you. How tall do you think this water clock is in feet? Go for it. It's okay. What do you think? More than 20 feet? Less than 30? More than 25? 26? Close. It is between 26 and 27. It's 26 and a half feet tall, making it the tallest water clock in North America. And it's here with us at the Children's Museum. I think that's pretty cool. We know that it's 26 and a half feet tall now. How much do we think it weighs in pounds? It is 4 digits. What do you think? Less than 5,000. Less than 10. Less than 4. 3,000 pounds. That is exactly right. That's about 2,500 pounds of glass, electrics, colored pipes that you see out there. That's all of that. That is about 500 pounds of water as well. Folks, in this water clock range, which is a few short moments, if you look up there at the number 60, it will be absolutely silent. So I'm going to need some help from all of you to make some noise. Like I said, there's about 500 pounds of water in here. So that means there's a lot of liquid in this water pot. Who's got a good water sound that they can make? Bubbles, whatever water sound you've got, hold on to it. I'll give you a cue when it's time. Folks, if you're just now joining us, keep your eyes down to number 60. You are about to see our water clock drain here in just a few short moments. All right, we are almost there, folks. Like I said, there's about 500 pounds of water in this water bottle, but we can bring it down even further. It holds about 70 gallons of liquid. That's 35 gallons of water, 35 gallons of methyl alcohol, and some blue dye. You might be curious as to why we keep methyl alcohol in the water bottle. The methyl alcohol helps keep the water clean and clear as it moves through the clock, so you can actually see it. The water might start to look like a dirty fish tank after a little while, but the methyl alcohol helps keep it clean and clear so you can see it move through the clock. Folks, you can see some water moving up there by the number 60. We are just moments away from this momentous 1 p.m. drain. All right, get your water sounds ready, boys and girls and grown-ups. Here we go. Water sound, water sound. 70 gallons of liquid, folks. We do better than this. 500 pounds, 70 gallons, you know, lots of water. Excellent work, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. You can hold on the water sounds. This clock will take approximately 6 minutes to completely drain it and reset itself, so I won't make you make water sounds for that long. Folks, feel free to stick around and watch the drain complete. Like I said, this is the only time it's going to happen today while you're here. I'll be down here for the next few minutes if you have any questions or want me to break anything else down for you. Otherwise, thanks for joining me and have a great afternoon with us here at the Children's Museum. Thanks again.
Yes. After it gets all the way down, I guess the problem is on the after drain.
When does it do this the second time? Midnight, yeah. From midnight to 1 a.m. and no one's here to see it. Upstairs. Four.
The bottom of this one's